2 years ago, director Wong Kar-wai achieved cult status with Chungking Express, a low-budget, high-energy look at the perils of modern romance. The movie struck a chord with metropolitan lovers around the world. Shot guerrilla style in the back alleys and front roofs of Hong Kong, it combined frenetic camera work with a wistful awareness of the difficulties of connecting emotionally in the teeming city. Quentin Tarantino snapped up Chungking Express for his distribution company, obviously responding to its energy and visual flair. Wong Kar-wai's latest picture, Fallen Angels, is equally stylish, but with a darker edge, its millennial mood reflecting the anxieties of the colony on the eve of being handed over to China. Moving Pictures asked the director for a guided tour of his city on the verge of a nervous breakdown.
If I didn't live in Hong Kong, my style would probably be different. The only way I can make a film in a place is I have to know the place well, the people well, and I think I know Hong Kong well. Chungking Mansion. And Chungking Express starts from here.
我是一个警察，我的名字叫做何志武，编号223。
This is the most busy place in Hong Kong. It's fast and it is confusing, you know. Anything can happen.
我们最接近的时候，我跟他的距离只有 0.01公分。 57个小时之后，我爱上了。
It's very much like a small, mini Hong Kong. The people living here are from different cultural backgrounds, and they squeeze in a limited space. This is the shop. This is the grocery stores where I buy the music for Chungking Express, the Indian music. It's not very expensive, it costs only $20 Hong Kong. This is the place where we shoot the shooting scene in Chungking Express, with Bridget Lin shooting two Indians. This is the place. I like this place, and I have a lot of fun shooting here.
我跟他最接近的时候，我们之间的距离只有 0.01公分。我对他一无所知。6个钟头之后，他喜欢了另外一个男人。
So this is Midnight Express, one of the key locations in Chungking Express and Fallen Angels. This is my cameraman, my DP, Chris Doyle.
Basically, you're shooting in these kind of places where we're going to get hustled off the street anyway. You're shooting in the airport or the MTR or Chungking Express where you're going to be shot if you stay more than 10 minutes, you know, in one place. So you kind of, you know, it's kind of, yeah, the style is dictated by the circumstances in which you work.
Oh my God, not you. Well, anyway, welcome anyway. This is where I live. In the film, this is basically where Tony Leung lives. And when he wasn't home, Fei Wong, who is like working in Midnight Express, she'd break in every day to see what this boy that she'd fallen in love with was really doing in his life. never let a film crew into your apartment. I lost most of my CDs, I lost my fax machine, the phone never worked again for a year. It was overtaken.
My first film, As Tears Go By, is quite successful critically and commercially. And my second film is not so good in box office because they expect something like a standard martial art movies. Most of the Hong Kong audience, they like linear narrations, very simple films. In fact, I don't know what my style is because I change from time to time. While I was making Chungking Express and Fallen Angels, they said, well, this guy making film very fast. When I was making Days of Being Wild, people said, well, he makes slow films.
Take my bill.
Why are you looking at your bill?
1 minute.
I think I would consider myself influenced by the East traditions more than the West. Maybe my films looks more westernized than other Chinese cinemas, Chinese filmmakers, but I think in the heart it is quite Eastern thinking. I'm very aware of time because it's gone and it won't come back. That is very Eastern. We have the paintings of Edward Hopper, and I said I want the film to be something like a monochrome. And there's a lot of green in the film.
We actually see very monochrome, because he's always wearing his sunglasses. I mean, you know, things seem to kind of dilute, you know, the colors a bit. Also, because I made some mistakes in the printing. So.
He put three filters in front of the lenses, so it's always have problems in focus.
We may have made a mistake, but we stuck with it. And there was enough support from him and from some of the people on the film that we had to preserve, you know, we had to go with it. And that you don't get every day. I don't think you get that in Hollywood. That's why we're not going.
There's offers, but I think I would like to stay to work for a few more years. To some directors, Hollywood is their dream, so if they want to do it, why not? China's going to take over Hong Kong next year, and nobody knows what will exactly happen. It's something which is very exceptional, and I think something interesting will happen here, so I'd rather stay. Hong Kong cinemas is quite different from Chinese cinemas. In China, they are more organized. They want to know exactly what you want. And Hong Kong is more flexible. So I think each party has to get used to each other for a certain time. But I think I will stay and make more films. First day of shootings, we work in a very small tea house. The only way we can do is to shoot with a wide-angle lens.
But I think we should do something more interesting. So I asked Chris to we have an extremely wide angle lens. He said yes. But in that case, the face of Michelle Rhee is, she looks like a banana. It was about space. We use a wide angle because these people are so close together but so distant, and the camera should be close to them, therefore you feel very close to them, but you know that they're really separated by a great distance of, incomprehensibility. You know, they can't talk to each other. That's after the fact. I mean, the real fact is, it was a small space and we had to get close, right? And then you start going in that direction and you say, hey, it's working, this is interesting. And then you try and put on another lens and you say, shit, I mean, anything else doesn't work. When you shoot a gun, the cameraman, if it's me, he usually goes, oh! So I think this is partly how the handhold style that we've developed together started. This distorted way in which things, move in and out of your perception, the way, things are blurred, time is blurred, the way things sort of jump, and suddenly you're in a different space than you realize it. It's how you perceive violence. He won't admit it. But I hope it's poetic. I hope it's about poetry. I hope it's about the poetry of life. I hope it's about the poetry of love, the poetry of the impossibility of, various things, and the consequences of certain choices. I'm sure a lot of it, and of course time. Because so much of your stuff is about time, then obviously, you play with the time in which the film passes through the camera. I mean, this seems to be a logical step.
That's fun. Talk like a film critic.
Yes, I've been reading Tony Raines all week.
And there's a special preview of Fallen Angels this Thursday at Nottingham's Shots in the Dark Festival.